Hello, my fellow warriors. My name is Hell Knight, and welcome back to another year of Spooky Season, where I will be breaking down the creepiest, darkest, and disturbing moments in animation history. So, today's video, I will be talking about the top 5 darkest moments in anime. Just to let you all know, this is just going to be in my personal opinion. Some of these on this list may not be dark moments in your eyes, but in my eyes, I just find this, kind of disturbing and just... Wow, they showed this, in anime. And also, spoilers ahead. So pretty much sit back, relax, while I'll be talking about the top 5 disturbing moments in anime. Connie's death in Promise to Neverland. So I'll just give you some context here. So one of our two main characters, Emma Stone, are saying goodbye to one of their adopted siblings named Connie, a six-year-old girl who they thought was going to get adopted. But when Emma realized that Connie's favorite stuffed toy she left behind, she quickly, goes away from the orphanage with Norman to try to find Connie to give her her toy back. But after they make it through the gates, they realize that they couldn't find Connie anywhere. But all they see was just, a truck. After they keep on searching, Emma looks inside the truck, curious to know what's inside it. But we just see a shocked face, gassed and stunned and frozen. As Norman tried to understand what's happening, they look inside and they saw Connie's dead body with a random rose sticking out of her chest. And then they realize that there's a bunch of demons eating Connie. Yeah, it's kind of fucked up. So they kind of realize that no, they are not in an orphanage. They are literally in a farm where they literally being, learned, eaten well, so they can be eaten by demons. And yeah, it's kind of fucked up. The reason why this is kind of messed up is because, these are demons literally eating, like, young children. And also, to make this more messed up, Connie was 6 years old. Let's just all stick that in. She could have had a future, but no. She was lied to by her, mother, Isabel, saying that she could get adopted by some lovely parents, but no. Like every other children before her, they all just were lied to, killed, and pretty much getting eaten up by demons. So pretty much, yeah, it's kind of, what makes it seem pretty much disturbing, because we know something's going on. We know something disturbing's going to happen, and flat out, we just saw a six-year-old's dead body just laying there dead, and everyone just has shock faces. I had a shock face, Emma and Norman had a shock face, and yeah, they kind of realize the truth that their entire lives have just been a lie, and that's why they have to try to escape. It's a really good show. Season 2 could have been better, but yeah, whatever. On to the next one. So, on our number 4 list is Law's backstory. If you all know what I'm talking about, then yeah, this is an absolute heartbeating backstory for a character. Now, when Law was a kid, he was born and raised in a country that had a deadly disease called amber lead poison. And also, to make things worse, that his country was in a war with another country. And when the disease was spreading fast, the world government pretty much, the world government kind of decided to, what do you think they did? Did they obviously make a cure for this? Even though the disease was uncurable, they could make a cure for it, like Chopper does. Nope, they decided to do a whole goddamn genocide on every person who was living on that country. A whole goddamn massacre, which pretty much nearly everyone was killed, besides Law. And when Law wanted, and Law literally had to hide in a pile of dead bodies of his friends and family so he won't get killed. This is just messed up. It generally just shows that the One Piece world is not really, all fun and loving and funny pirates with wacky powers, isn't it? It generally shows that this world is not really worth living in. Like, the world government literally decided to just kill innocent people because they had a deadly disease, and it kind of messed up. Hell, in one of the recent chapter 1095, the world government, or the Celestial Dragons, literally have a 3-year game where they literally pick an island and hunt down the people on that island. That is so goddamn messed up. It just wow. But it's just an absolute disturbing backstory how Law had to survive all of this. It just really messed up. Number 3, Attack on Titan. Now you're probably wondering, here and now, what do you mean, just Attack on Titan? Should you not be Pacific? Yeah, here's the thing, I cannot be Pacific because every goddamn moment of this anime is just a dark moment. Now I will list off some of the dark moments I found because I could have picked one, but I just couldn't. This was just hard for me to do on this list. So I just pick a couple and I'll just name them here and just show the disturbing photos. Okay, let's go. Me and you together. Okay, let's do this. Eren's mom's death being eaten by a titan. Bertel being eaten by a titan. What else? The rumbling. Sasha's death. One of the main characters, Eren, being turned into a psychopathic villain. Then Eren committing entire genocide on a town. And many, 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 many more dark moments in this anime. Now you're all probably wondering, Hero Nights, Attack on Titan is supposed to be a dark anime. What the hell are you talking about, you insane person? Yes, I know this. I obviously knew this while writing the goddamn script. But I don't know, it was hard for me to I don't know, pick a dark moment for this, so yeah. Like, it's like Berserk. Berserk was designed to be a dark moment. I haven't seen Berserk, but I will watch it one day, so yeah. Shut up. Number 2, the death of Jinpei from Jujutsu Kaisen. So this one is the most tragic one because we could have a character who could have been part of the main cast, but we didn't, and I'll tell you why. Well, I already said it, but I'll tell you where it leads up to. So Junpei didn't really have a good life, well, mostly at school because he was getting picked on, bullied, and the teachers didn't really seem to care about that. Well, no, I don't want to say care, they just didn't notice. They thought the bullies were his friends, but they were stupid enough to think that they were his friends. Like, really? Could you not check? Could you not do that? Teachers these days, wow. But yeah, he didn't really have a good life until he met Mahito, and Mahito told him about curse technique, that lot, the power system. Jinbei was pretty much, it's like I'm saying Jinbei from One Piece, but no, it's Junbei. But Junbei was he thought he made a friend, an actual friend, but then a few days later, his mum died by holding Sukuna's finger, so curse killed her for that. And then Jinbei went on a rampage, he was killing one of the bullies. Then he met Yuji, then they got into a fight. But then we get to the moment where Mahito comes in and tells him that, yeah, I'm the one who did it, I killed your mom. Well, the curse did, but I put Sukuna's fingers there. I did it. It was all me, bruv. It was all me. Then, sadly, we get him transforming into a cursed monster. He attacks Yuji, and Yuji even tells Sukuna to, like, bruv, just, well, he didn't really tell him, bruv. He didn't tell him that. He told him to help him, but Sukuna just laughs it off, and so does Mahito. And as Junpei keeps on attacking Yuji, Junpei was on his last breath, and as he slowly goes down on the floor, he says these last words, "Why?" And then he dies. I think generally what makes this more sad and impactful, because Junpei could have been saved. He actually he if you know if Sukuna wasn't a heartless villain, he actually could have been, part of the main cast. He could have been chilling with Yuji and his friends, but this is the world of Jujutsu Kaisen, and a lot of characters you love die. Okay, so before we get into number one, we have some honorable mentions. These were originally going to be on this list, but I was just too lazy and I really just want to get this video out. So, on our number one honorable mention, we have the Kuta Clan Massacre. A bunch of fucked up villains killed an innocent tribe to steal their eyes for money. Pretty messed up. We have Experimenting on Your Child from Fullmetal Alchemist. To be honest, I have not seen this anime. I don't really know the concept of the entire show. I just know that scene only. It's really disturbing that a father literally experimented on his daughter and his dog and combined them together. It's really messed up. On the next, we have Dobby's Dance from My Hero Academia. You thought your son was dead for years, but no, he's alive and well, and he's been killing innocent people for years. And the last one, we have the Celestial Dragons. If you know, you know. Now, our number one disturbing moment in anime is Shigaraki kills his family. Yeah, so in my opinion, this is kind of, well, not the darkest anime scene in history of all of anime. I just find this kind of, I would say, one of my favorite disturbing moments in anime, if I could say that correctly. But I'll just lead you up to it. So Shigaraki, you know, one of the main villains of My Hero Academia, he has a pretty good backstory, so I'm just gonna explain it to you. So Shigaraki pretty much grew up in a pretty alright home, pretty nice house. The only problem is that his father didn't really like him and his sister playing superheroes. It's because his father, I'm just gonna reference him as father. I'm generally not bothered saying his name because I'm just so lazy. His father generally just didn't like him playing superheroes because his mother was a superhero, but she spent more time being a superhero than hanging out with him. So he kind of had a grudge against superheroes. So literally, he would literally abuse Shigaraki for pretty much talking about or even playing superheroes, and it was generally just messed up. So one fateful night, Shigaraki was just outside crying because his father was abusing him. Father of the Year, by the way. And soon his dog just came over just to comfort him, you know, what dogs do. But suddenly something happened. Something changed. His dog was dead. Shigaraki was just shocked. He didn't know what happened. What makes it worse that his sister saw, and she was gonna send for help, but Shigaraki told her to, like, you know, wait, understand. But then when he grabbed her, she also died. She turned to dust. Then everyone went, nearly like his mother, his grandparents, literally all went outside. And as Shigaraki pressed the floor, the entire ground crumbled, and literally everyone just was outside, was just dead. His mother, his grandparents were just dead, and sadly, his father saw literally everything. And instead of, you know, comforted him, he literally just grabbed like a pole and just literally beat the shit out of him. Well, not really beat the shit, he like smacked him across the face, and that just led Shigaraki to just straight up kill him, just put his hands on his face and turn him to dust. So generally, this backstory is generally just a horrific backstory. I'm just kind of just about just like abuse in general. And like, it generally just shows Shigaraki's father was just a bit of an asshole, because it's just very traumatic. It generally just shows that when your power in this world or quirk gets awakened or like activates, you just activates randomly. You just don't know how to control it. You don't know what to do. It's a new experience, and it's just so goddamn out there. It could be a deadly power. And sadly, Shigaraki got the decay quirk that allows him to pretty much turn everything he touched into dust with his five fingers. It's just absolute traumatic for a child like that. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this new year of spooky months. I hope you all enjoyed it. I hope you guys liked and subscribe and hit that weird bell to get notified by any video. And again, if you guys have any other dog moments you wish was in this video, leave it down in the comments down below then so I can read it. And in the meantime, I'll see you guys next time. Bye. Startling chilly screams. They'll sneak under sarcophagus and just won't leave you be.